founded the Air Medical Memorial in 2009 in response to one of the deadliest years on record for the air medical industry. There were 8 separate accidents and 24 crew members lost their lives in the line of duty. The memorial will provide a place to remember, reflect, and most importantly, heal. While the memorial does include the names of honorees, it doesn't give you a sense of who these people were as individuals, and that's an important part of the story. To better understand just who we have lost and the impact of that loss, we decided to create Project Tribute. The tribute film will include the sentiment of friends, family members, colleagues, co-workers, fallen crew members, and some of this film was shot by the individuals contributing that material, as well as interviews that were conducted by the Air Medical Memorial for Project Tribute. In addition to video, we've received photographs, poems, audio clips, drawings, personal effects, various items that are really going to help us tell the story of who these people were.
Erin had a lot of friends, and it's because she was good at it. She's good at being a friend, and she would do anything for you. You know, she is definitely the person that people would call on in times of need, and she would be there without fail. I know that she was the kind of person that her partners would always appreciate flying with, because no matter what situation you got into, you know, they felt like they could handle it with Erin and their skills together. And she was just the kind of person that could do anything. One of my friends who also worked for Airlift was there, and she got a phone call, and her face just fell. I said, "What's wrong?" And she put the phone aside and she said, "Airlift 4 is missing 45 minutes. And my next question was obviously who's on board. And she said, "Erin and Lois and Steve." And I just knew. I knew they were gone. Because there was no good reason for that aircraft or those people to be missing for 45 minutes. Eventually, they found the debris field in the water. It was hard enough to lose one person, but to lose 3 at one time. Erin was really larger than life. She was a great friend. Erin had introduced one of our friends, Drew, to the surf clam. And after Erin died, every time we all go out for sushi, Drew and I and whoever else knew Erin order a surf clam, and we toast with it in her memory. And if you've ever had a surf clam, you'll know what a tribute that is. You know, we had some really good times. And when we reminisce about that, it keeps their memory alive.